situation that happened last year. My cousin was affected by procrastination. My cousin was a really good student until 9th grade. She was the best student of her class, always with the best grades until she started procrastinating. When high school started, she didn't know what she would do concerning her professional career. Then she started procrastinating. She started sleeping during classes, talking a lot, not doing her homework, and because of her exemplary grades in past years, she could pass the first and the second year of high school. When she started the last year, she couldn't keep up with it. Her grades were under the expectation, and all her friends, teachers, and everyone in our family started getting worried about her. Worried, thinking that she would fail. And like everyone thought, she failed. Procrastination destroyed my cousin's life and can destroy yours too. The meaning of procrastination is the action of delaying or postponing something. The first thing is to avoid procrastination. This problem can be considered a huge problem. It's something that no one wants. Once start happening, it's very difficult to stop. Procrastination happens when the second you take control over your mind. The second you is someone that only thinks about the present and only cares about what will make you happy at the moment, not thinking about the consequences. Different of the first you that have rational decisions and think about the future. Now let's see a non-procrastinator brain. Rational decision maker. I don't think that makes sense. I think long term. I'm not a child. And now let's see a procrastinator brain. Rational decision maker. I have the same goals as the guy in the boat truck. We are the same. Instant gratification monkey. In this drawing, the second move is being considered like a monkey. Notice anything different? It seems the first you in the procrastinator brain is coexisting with the bad, the second you. This would be fine even if the first you know the first thing about how to own a pet. But it wasn't part of his training. And the monkey makes it impossible for him to do his job. And that's how worked our procrastinator brain. I was searching on the internet to prepare this TED talk, and I found a research made by a team member. I prepared all my TED talk based on that. Before I read the research, I was stranded in this topic. When I read, I got so interested that I decided to talk about that. On the research, I read about the Eisenhower The Eisenhower matrix places anything you can spend your time doing on two spectrums. One going from the most urgent possible path to the less urgent. And the other going from the particularly important to totally inconsequential. And using this as axis, divide your world in four quadrants. And that's how a non-procrastinator matrix works. 1. Do now. 2. Decide when to do it. 3. Delegate away. 4. Delay. And that's how a procrastinator matrix works. 1. Do when it goes from urgent to apparently dire. 2. Delegate to future you. 3. Do when Q1 is urgent. And 4. Do now, maybe also just do for. If you want any information, on quadrant 4, direction, places to meet, just ask a procrastinator. They live there. For a non-procrastinator, quadrant 4 is a happy place to spend time only. They don't pass all their day there. As for quadrants 1 and 3, the urgent quadrants, most procrastinators will end up there time to time. make them think that they are doing something, but it's not true. And then there's quadrant two. To a procrastinator, is a strange and foreign land, far, far away, kind of Narnia. He knows it's an important place, and he's tried many times to go there. But there's a bigger problem. There's a big problem. The second new pet repels by it. And there's two kinds of procrastinators. The first one is the disastrous. That is the worst. They are permanently camped out in Q4. And procrastination is destroying their lives. A procrastinator becomes a disastrous for one of two reasons. The first one is their second new pet has become all powerful. And the second one is they are a normal procrastinator in a life situation with no external deadlines or pressure. And the second one is the impulsionator. The impulsionator seems productive, but he's really an impulsive. A procrastinator wearing a productive person mask. By spending all of his work time in Q3, he seems busy. He is busy, but he never seems to make much progress in his real goals. Goes back and forth between Q4 and Q3. Sometimes quadrant 3 disguises itself as a quadrant 1. A busy impulsionator often believes that the urgent work he is consumed with is important. But the problem with that is what Eisenhower himself said best. What is important is seldom urgent, and what is urgent is seldom important. The major lesson here is to beware of Q3. And if you are not careful, Q3 will end with your life. There are bigger problems in the world than procrastination. All makes procrastination seems rarely like a problem of the privileged. Something to suffer over those who have no real suffering. It also the word loss for every Steve Jobs, John Lennon, or J.K. Rowling, or anyone else whose talents haven't answered our lives. There are thousands of people with just as much potential who has never achieved much for the world because they wasted away their time in the wrong quadrants. We need to develop well thought-out definition of urgent and important, which will be different for everyone and requires a deep dig into the highly personal question. What matters most to me? Once you feel clear on your Eisenhower matrix and where its various corners lie, you will need to do the hardest part and gain control over how you spend your time. But whether you think you can or think you can't, you are right. Henry Ford. You just need to believe in yourself, have a positive thought, and you can do everything you want. All depends on you, so go ahead and do it. And remember the girl that I was talking on the beginning? Well, now she's doing the last year again, she's stopped procrastinating. Now she's going well, and she's not the best student of her class. But her grades are getting better and better, and maybe she will research a tech. So what I want to say, telling you this story, is that procrastinating can ruin your life. Depending on the situation, you can lose your job, make someone get mad at you, or worse. Procrastination will never be good. Avoiding procrastination. Will make your life easier and better. All you need to do is believe in yourself, so go through procrastination and win.